person, I get asked this question a lot. Legally, I'm a homeschooler, and that is my go-to short answer. But the term, homeschooling, doesn't really provide much information. Yes, there are a few common assumptions, stereotypes almost, about what homeschooling looks like. The most common seems to be that we recreate school at home, with my mom acting as my teacher. But in reality, every homeschooling family has their own unique program. Our homeschooling style is very experiential. To me, a teacher is anything I can learn from. And I like to learn by doing. So I go out into the community and participate in the real world. I don't separate my time into school hours and out of school hours. And I don't say, this is educational and this is non-educational. I don't have a name for my learning style either, though I sometimes call it life learning. I know this is a really unique way to approach education, and it has naturally led me to develop a pretty unique way of thinking about learning and about my life. I think I'm learning more than just school subjects. I think I'm learning about learning. An idea that really fascinates me is the idea of optimization. A lot of people nowadays are talking about how to optimize their lives. So I started thinking, how can I optimize my learning? And I realized that it's not just about what I'm learning. Yes, that's important, but what's also important is how I'm learning. Although there are opportunities for learning all around me, no one can teach me anything unless I'm willing to learn. It's all about my mindset, and I have to be conscious about it. Deliberately learning how to learn can help me learn. The first thing I recognize about the process of learning is that it comes in stages. Every time I embark on a new learning journey, there's a beginning, a middle, an end, and a destination. Each phase is unique, but they're all equally important. To me, the beginning is about curiosity. As I mentioned before, I have to be willing. But not just willing, I have to be eager. At some fundamental level, I have to care. I have to want to learn. And I do. You see, when I was younger, I had a lot of free time. My favorite memories from childhood were of the long hours I spent tinkering and being creative. I followed my curiosity wherever it led me, and I developed a deep love of learning. But as I got older, I started to set specific learning goals. Instead of just wandering, I was making a path with a specific destination. And so naturally, I'm starting to encounter some challenges. You see, it's easy to have curiosity at the beginning of a learning journey, but it's not so easy to keep up that excited energy in the face of a challenge. One of the programs I participate in that emphasizes both experiential learning and community involvement is 4-H. I joined 4-H with a focus on science and leadership, and I've participated in their public speaking event every year since I was 8. My first presentation was just a breeze. I got to talk about my cat and how to take care of her. I got to see all my friends do their presentations. It was so much fun. But as I got older, the topics I chose got more and more complex. I would start out all excited, and I would research enough to write a PhD dissertation. But at some point, I had to actually write my talk. And that's when life got real. I would get overwhelmed and frustrated. I would panic and procrastinate. And I would question, why am I doing this? This is not mandatory. I always struggled through, and I was glad I did it in the end. But over the years, I started to see a pattern. In the beginning, it was easy. It's easy to start something. And in the end, I was glad I did it, and I had fun giving the actual presentation. It was in the middle where I was getting stuck. And I started to wonder, do I have to drag myself through the all comes down to the mindset behind my responses. I think that when I panic, it really comes out of a fixed mindset. I somehow believe that I've reached the limits of my abilities, and that the challenge is an indicator of failure. But if, instead of panicking, I can pause and then problem solve, that would really require me to have a growth mindset, to recognize that challenge is an inevitable part of the learning journey, and that smarts and skills can be developed. The thing about this mindset-based approach is that it does not come naturally to me. It really requires me to be self-aware. I have to pay attention to my thoughts. Honest self-reflection really means that I'm taking responsibility, not only for my mindset, but also for my strategy and my progress. Because at the end of the day, I have to ask myself, what is all this learning for? Some might say that my education is to prepare me to be an adult, so I can make a living and contribute to society. That when I'm an adult, what I do will matter. But I believe that what I do matters right now, and not only for myself, but also for my family, my community, and my world. And I'm not alone in this belief. I am so inspired by my peers, who more and more of us are optimizing our lives and our educations. We're following our passions, and we're making our voices heard to solve real-world problems. I believe that I'm going to be learning for the rest of my life.